Hiya, welcome everybody to Latif's Inspired. Today I will be cooking a very nice sea bass dish. So for seafood lovers, I've had a fantastic coriander fish one, so that inspired me to actually do the sea bass dish. I love sea bass, it's very nice. It doesn't have all the bones, you just take the middle bones out. You go to the supermarket, they'll do it for you. Today I went to Asda, bought from Asda two nice fillets, and I'm gonna cook it and show you a very traditional with a nice twist. Again, my recipes, my style of cooking. So sorry if I offend people from certain cultures, if I don't cook it their way, but this is how I like it, this is how I cook it. And this is my take on it and my recipes. So a sea bass with new potatoes and some little cherry tomatoes as well. Beautiful, gorgeous dish, Bengali style sea bass dish. As you can see, I've slightly just scored it, so just a few lines, about three lines there. It's gonna let the marination penetrate. Also, the fish isn't gonna become a banana shape sort of thing. So yeah, so this is very important to do. It keeps the fish its shape, and also the marination penetrates. So I'm gonna marinate it slightly with a bit of spice, and I'll show you shortly. So I'm just using half a teaspoon of turmeric, half a teaspoon of chilli, half a teaspoon of salt, and just maybe about a couple of 1 teaspoon of just vegetable oil. This is going to help the marination mix. So that's it really. So hands are washed, don't worry. There. So lightly just marinated. So I've marinated it, mixed it nicely, both sides as you can see. Make sure to mix it properly, guys. You don't want a bit where it's too chilly, bit where it's too salty, so it's very important you marinate, you mix this properly, and you leave this in the fridge for about 20 minutes to about half an hour. Then you start the cooking process, guys. So basically, I've got a nice flat pan, and what I do, as you always know, I just slightly dust it with a bit of flour, so it just doesn't tend to stick. The reason why it's popping, there's a little bit of moisture, like water, on the oil. So pan is smoking, it's nice and hot. That was just basically a tablespoon of oil to help me pan fry the fish, guys. So now for these babies. Skin side down, guys, first. Now I'm going to let this cook for a few minutes each side. Also, this process helps prevent the fish from breaking in the sauce. So when you pan fry it lightly, keeps it nice and together. And also, it just has a beautiful flavour because you're sealing it, and the moisture and the flavor stays in the fish. Then when you put it into the sauce, it sort of releases its fishiness. So hopefully you'll have a beautiful dish. Right, the fish, as you can see here, is sort of slightly changing color. So you know that side is cooking. It's a medium high heat. So I'm gonna just lower the heat slightly a little bit. And I'm gonna turn the fish, guys. Got a beautiful crust on it, and it hasn't sort of curled up into a banana. So that's literally been 2 minutes, guys. It was on a high heat. I just lowered the heat. So give it 2 minutes and that'll be fine, guys. Right, it's been a couple of minutes on both sides. Yep, that's about done, guys, if you can see this. Yep. So now I'm going to let the fillets rest for a bit and I'm going to start on the sauce. So it's a quarter cup of oil. This is half a cup, but I've used quarter. Now I'm going to heat up the oil, guys. There's about 2 teaspoons of mustard seeds. I just need them to start popping. Once it starts popping, then I add the next ingredient. When it starts popping, it releases its flavours. Yeah, that's crackling, popping away. I'm going to add a couple of bay leaf. Now this is about 1 cup of grated onion. I'm using 1 teaspoon of salt here, guys. This will soften up the onions and make the cooking process faster, because when the salt touches the, when it's mixed with the onions, it loosens it up and the water it releases from the onions. As you can see, so on the edges, some of the onions are becoming golden, so this is what I'm looking for. So it's literally been a few minutes, guys. Now I'm gonna add the next ingredient. So that's 1. That's 2 heaped teaspoon of garlic. I like a lot of garlic in my fish dishes, it brings out the flavor. So this is gonna be a few more minutes, guys. The onions are turning brown, which is beautiful. I'm gonna add a splash of water. Reason for the flame is because of the heat. So put the lid on, give that a minute or so, let the onions sweat down, and then you'll be ready for the spices. It's cooking away beautifully. Now I'm gonna add this. This is for the color, and it also brings out a nice flavor to it. So a few pieces of red, few pieces of green peppers. I'm going to use these chilies. I want to keep it whole, but just take the tip off and it just releases all the flavor and the spiciness. So again, because I haven't used too much water, oil is drying up, so splash of water. Put the lid back on. Let it soften up a couple more minutes. I'm going to put the gas down to a medium low. It was on a medium high before. So I've used 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric, and I've used 1 teaspoon of a general curry powder you can buy from the shops, but I've got my own spice too. That is my mix. 1/2 teaspoon of chili powder. The 1/2 teaspoon is good for this dish. It's spicy, but it's not overpoweringly hot, and it's definitely not bland, as in mild. But if you can't, this is very flavoursome, so it definitely won't be bland. Even if you don't like it too spicy, you can add less or none at all. It's spicy enough because it's got the green chilies there. And this is coriander. Fish and coriander goes very nice together. So this is 2 teaspoons of coriander, guys. So that goes in. I'm giving it a slight mix. The spices, when it goes into the onion, the oil, it sort of livens it up. Now this is grated tomato. I've just blended it down, seeds and all. So 1 cup, guys. This builds a nice, thick, rich sauce, which is very, very important. As you can see, the colour has changed as well. I'm just going to put up the heat slightly a little bit. I'm going to use about a tablespoon and a half of tomato puree, guys. I'm going to let this cook out for a few minutes. Literally been about a minute, guys. One of the second main ingredient are the baby potatoes. Now you can boil this first and then add it, but I'm going to give some TLC and cook it properly because I want the flavors to go in, penetrate the potatoes. It'll be a phenomenal taste. I'm adding 1 cup of water. Basically, this is the water's there just to cook the potatoes. So that will, the potatoes will probably take about 10 minutes. So the whole process has been about 12 minutes currently. So that's it. I'm gonna put the lid on. It's on a medium high heat. I'm gonna give it about 10 minutes cooking time. I'm gonna make myself a cup of tea and I'll come back to the process. It's been about 5 minutes, guys. I stirred it in the middle because you don't want the sauce to stick. So I'm gonna check the potato, guys. Yeah, that looks cooked to me. Slightly bit hard in the middle, but that's new potatoes. Baby potatoes are sort of like that. So I'm going to use a half a cup of water now. Put the heat up a bit now. As you can see, the tomatoes and the grated onions made this thick gravy rather than BIR cooking when it's, you use the gravy. This is the flavors of all the spices. This actual dish has, you're gonna taste the flavor from the gravy. So the fish goes in now. I tend to put a skin side down. It sort of holds the fish together. Bury the fish in your sauce. Basically, what you're doing here, you just want the fish to release its flavor into the sauce. Now these are the cherry tomatoes, so it's on the vine, so I'm just going to sort of steam cook it. And this is on a sort of low heat. I've got a few slices of lemon. This just lifts the whole flavor. So there we go. Now I'm gonna cook this for a further 5 minutes. It's on low heat, guys. The tomatoes have softened up, the skin has split, so it's ready. The potatoes are done, fish is ready. I'm gonna turn the gas off and start plating up, guys. So guys, this is a very traditional Bengali style way of cooking, but I've used a sea bass, reason being most of the Bengali fishes, they come from Bangladesh frozen, and we use frozen fish, whereas a sea bass, it's a very beautiful flavor. It's got that meatiness, that fishiness, and you can actually use it, and it does taste like the Bengali style of fish, and it goes very well with spices. So give it a try, guys. My sea bass special with the baby potatoes, and it's got all the flavors that a Bengali style dish is, and it's a restaurant-y style dish. Very nice, and my customers absolutely loved it when it was on the menu, so I thought you'd try it at home, guys. Sea bass special. And again, if you liked what you've seen, thought my tips were very good and useful, helpful, please don't forget to like the and make a comment so I know what you're thinking about, and most importantly, make sure you subscribe, guys. Thank you very much for tuning in to Latif's Inspired.